Welcome to the video news of the week. New Hampshire Fish and Game Department Executive Director Scott Mason has announced that he'll be stepping down from his position after his term ends in August of next year. Mason's four-year term began in August 2020. A Stratford resident, Mason has been the first department head from Coos County since the 1970s.
I think one of the differences up here is fish and game tends to touch a lot of our economy up here. The interaction between fish and game and different businesses certainly plays a major role in our economy.
The Fish and Game Commission meets on December 21st and anticipates the search for his replacement will start then. In their ongoing tour of the North Country, Santa and Mrs. Claus made a stop in downtown Colebrook last Sunday. The pair rode in by Colebrook fire truck to light the tree on Main Street.
Well, we got to see what time it is.
The pair traveled north to Noyes Chevrolet, where a long line of people awaited them. The duo will also be appearing at the Great Northwood Center for the Arts this coming Sunday, December 10th.
The Quilts of Valor Foundation presented quilts to service members and veterans at the George L. O'Neill American Legion Post 62 in Colebrook, with a ceremony held this past week. Eight individuals were recognized by the foundation, who thanked them for their service and presented each with their own individually unique quilts.
We don't want to wait to let our veterans know, and some of them have waited long enough. So if you know of anyone that you would like to nominate, I have given a form to Barbara, and I have some other forms here that you can do to nominate other veterans. Or you can go on the Quilts of Valor Foundation website and do it online yourself. Quilts of Valor Foundation wishes to recognize you for your service to our nation. We consider it our privilege to do so, though we may never know the extent of your sacrifice to protect and defend the United States of America. We award you this Quilt of Valor as an expression of gratitude from a grateful nation.
The stage at the Tillotson Center was awash with color as area students presented their production of Finding Nemo Jr. this past weekend. The show was an adapted musical rendition of the longtime favorite Pixar animation.
No need to worry, Dad, I'll be okay.
I'm scared you'll end up as a clownfish fillet. Where are we going, you?
Yeah, I'll be all right.
Here we are at the drop-off, where our dream ends and the vast open ocean stretches on for miles.
Whoa, nothing but blue as far as the eye can see.
Stay close, but remember, we keep our superesophageal ganglions to ourselves.
Whoa, what's that?
Oh, Sandy's patient says it's called a boat.
It's actually pronounced butt.
That's a pretty big butt.
As part of the Hope for the Season extravaganza sponsored by the Canaan Naturally Connected organization, the Thicker Than Water Trio performed a mixture of holiday favorites and popular tunes at the Grace Community Church this past Sunday afternoon.
She's fair, she's wild, Lord, she doesn't look like me. She may be loved morning, she's a holiday at sea. The New York streets are red, busy as they always used to be.
Took all the trees and put them in a tree.
And the
it's alright. Blackbird sings of dead man, take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You were always hoping for this moment to arrive.
On Friday, the Heather Pierson Trio provided a well-received Charlie Brown Christmas concert, bringing alive the music from the perennial holiday animated special. The show was presented by the Great Northwoods Center for the Arts and was sponsored by James Russ Finch.
Friday's weather brings sunshine with a high of 24 degrees and a low of 13. Saturday turns to cloud coverage with a high of 38, and Sunday brings rain with a high of 41 and a low of 31 degrees. Thank you for watching the Video News of the Week.